Pew, pew, pew.
Okay, I mean, sorry, this is Jen. Today I am here with a shoulder workout. Now let me keep it real with you, because you know that's what I am. I am real. I really don't train my upper body anymore. Ever since I started to give myself these new goals of trying to get my lower body to catch up with my upper body, yes, I do snatches and sometimes I do push press, but I don't actually bodybuild train my shoulders. But they have maintained the gains of throughout the years of the type of training and mentality that I have behind shoulders. So I am gonna run through a shoulder workout that I have done in the past, and I will tell you what my secret is to my shoulders. Overtrain the hell out of them. So I would train shoulders one day of shoulders, but then on my two back days, I would add in rear delts. So I do, and rear delts is the kicker. I'm all about two back exercises or three back movements for every push. Three pull for every push, because we're all so protracted anyway when we're sitting on the computers, driving, so you have to train your body in the opposite motion. So I do a lot more rear delts than I do lateral raises or front raises. So I'm gonna grab some light weights, I'm gonna warm up, and then I'm gonna kind of go through a few of the different moves. I'll tell you some reps and stuff like that. Okay, so one thing I'll do is lateral raises, just a few of them. I might do like a set of 15, but I am gonna come back to them just to warm up my medial delt. Now, one thing that people don't really realize is when you're turning out like this, you're not really working your medial delt anymore, okay? And it's, you don't have to get the weight all the way up here. You just have to focus on lifting with your shoulders. So yeah, you're holding on to weights, but think that you're a puppet lifting with the elbows, okay? So, perfect form, like this. Okay, doesn't have to go any higher than this. 19 and 20. Okay, so typically, again, just a few sets of them. Then immediately, I'm gonna go to an exercise that I believe John Meadows made up. They're called swings. So I would then go over, and this was kind of my warm up. Then I would go with incline bench swings. When you do swings, you want to go heavy. So I will either go heavy and do a set of 2 to 3 sets of 30, or I will do a drop set and I will do 25, 25, 25. So I'll go real heavy, then medium, then light. So I'm gonna just show you how to do them, the difference between a rear delt and a swing, and then I'm gonna demo a few, okay? So I'm gonna get my bench ready. Oh, the bench doesn't go into an incline. Huh. Let's, she's on that one. Oh, it does go into it. All right, so probably about this high. Yeah, about this high is gonna be better for you, okay? So here's what the difference. When you do a swing, you swing, release, and just let the weight drop. Swing, release. With a rear delt, control, control. So we don't want the control on the down, we want the swing on the up, hence swings. Say, as I'm doing this, if you do the high volume that I mentioned, when you're done with either your 30 or your 50 or your 75, I try to do as many as I can here so you can see how pumped my rear delts will be. I don't know how many that is. 100. Okay. So, nice little pump in your rear delts. Okay. So, you really only have to do either, like I said, 3 sets of 30, or you want to do one big giant drop set of 75. Okay. That's it. We're going to move on to the next one. To replenish. Okay. All right. So, I kind of made this one up myself one day. It is a front raise exercise. Now, there are two ways that I like to do it. The second way is the way that I made up. So, what I would typically like to do, or what I have typically like to do is, I start out, let's just say, with front raises, 15-pound dumbbells, and I do alternating. And I kind of like to go a little bit to the center so that you really feel that anterior delt here, okay? So I will alternate, and I'll just bring the knees and slightly come across. Okay? Now, since this is kind of light, I would go with 15 on each side. I will immediately put them down, take a break, go over, grab 20s, do 10 on each side, put them down, 25s, and I've gone up to like, I think 30s or 35s, okay? So slowly work your way up. You don't necessarily have to superset this one with anything. However, I will say, I usually do superset just again to get a good stretch. I'll do the band open, and I will actually demo that in a second. But the exercise that I really want to show you guys that I think I kind of made up myself is it's poor posture. So whenever I'm telling, let's say, my clients to do it, I tell them I want you to have poor posture when you're doing this, and then you're going to lift, and it shouldn't be heavy, okay? So I'm going to grab two 10-pound dumbbells, and then I'm going to also show you what I do with my feet, okay? So let me put this back. So you're seated. I like to put my feet on a dumbbell like this. Grab my two dumbbells. Slightly lean forward and bring my shoulders together and then lift. Again, it does not have to be heavy. And 100. You will definitely feel that, especially after you just finished going up on your alternating front raises. So, we're gonna go to another exercise, but somebody's on it right now. So we're gonna take a little break and we'll be back in 2 seconds. Okay, so next thing that I would normally do once my shoulders are nice and warm, and here's the thing, little side note here. If you wanna get stronger on shoulder press, which there was a very long time that I never even did shoulder press and I still had nice shoulders, because there are a lot of people that can't press above their head. So you could still do front raises, rear delts, lateral raises, all different hand positions, lateral raise, leading with the pinky, leading with the thumb, coming from behind, palms down, tubes, cables, bands, whatever it is. But if you want to get stronger on shoulder press, here's a little tip for you. Some days start with shoulder press, some days end with shoulder press, and try to do the same weight. And then the next time you do it in the beginning of the workout, go a little bit heavier. Then do it at the end of the workout, try to do the same weight. Then the next time, go a little heavier, okay? So that's how you're gonna really challenge yourself on an exercise that you wanna build, that you wanna get stronger on, okay? So I'm just gonna show you, give you a, like, I'm gonna demonstrate one set on shoulder press. You do not have to lock out at the top. Everybody thinks that you do. The lockout is really more triceps than it is shoulders. So as long as you have tension on the shoulders here and then you press up to this point, you can still feel it in the shoulders, okay? So I'm just gonna grab 35s, something light, okay? And I'll show you how I get them up too. You could do them leaning back, make sure the seat's all the way up, or you could do them without, so you can get a little core, challenge your core, by not even leaning back on the seat. So you gotta keep your abs nice and tight. You know I'm all about that core, okay? I'm gonna pop one up. I'm not leaning. I mentioned earlier about like front raises or lateral raises that I do like to superset them with, because I'm all about overtraining the rear delts. So I use the X bands. red band. You can even use a black one. And what I do is I'm going to teach you how to do this exercise the correct way. Okay, you want to have tension in the band. So right now my rear delts are fired just by holding the tension. And then you pull it all the way apart until you squeeze your lower back. I mean, squeeze your arms. And until the band touches you. Stop. Boom. Tension. A lot of tension. Tension, a lot of tension. So I will literally bang out 20 of these in between as a superset to my front raises or my lateral raises, okay? Still, again, massive pump on my rear delts. Okay, now I'm about to work my rear delts again. And there is a way that you can incorporate the band because I'm all about supersetting opposite. So if we're gonna do rear delts here, I'm gonna wanna do, let's say, like a front raise with my band, okay? And if I just did dumbbell front raises, I'm not gonna superset it again. And again, typically, I have not mentioned this, but a lot of my sets, a lot of my sets are anywhere from 15 reps, or the front raise is 10-10, 12 reps at the absolute lowest, 4 sets, unless I'm trying to see how heavy I can go on the shoulder press. Maybe I started with 30s, and then I was trying to see how heavy. I think the heaviest I've ever done is 55s. So I obviously kept going because I wanted to try the 55s. Okay. So with this exercise, a lot of people do it different ways. You might see somebody like this as they're doing it. That's not really great form, okay? So you wanna find the position that you can get yourself in where the hand is right here. So that again, when you pull open, you're pulling open like a T. You don't have to go all the way back here, okay? So lightweight here, okay? Keep your head straight. A little fun fact for you. People ask me about my traps all the time. I do not train my traps, but I have them. Now, if you want to engage your traps when doing a rear delt exercise, lift your head up slightly. If you want to take your traps out of the equation, put them down. So because my traps are huge already, anytime I was doing rear delts, I would always make sure my head was down, okay? So I just, this is as far as you need to go. I like to keep my hands open so I could just focus on squeezing back. So as I mentioned earlier, when I was talking about that lateral raise, that it's just the weight, okay? You're the puppet. So like you lift with your elbows, you just pull back. Mind-muscle connection, you have to envision where you're supposed to be squeezing, what muscle you're working. Because I'm not even on the pec deck, but I feel it in my rear delts because I'm forcing the engagement, okay? So with this one also, I'll try to see how heavy I can go, and I like to end with a drop set on this one. So I might start with whatever, I mean that was kind of light, so I'll go up, and then whatever my heaviest was, so let's just say it'll be like 15 reps, then I'll do another set of 15, then 12, then 12, then 10, and then my last set is 8, 10, 12, 12, all the way back down, the exact number that I did, almost like a leg press. You go all the way from 8-9 plates all the way down to just one plate, and that's what I like to do here. And then, as I mentioned earlier, superset that with front raise on the band, so I'm gonna demo that, and then we could be done with shoulders. It's a small muscle group. You do not have to be in here for an hour and a half like you would for legs. Okay, so I'm gonna stand on my band, one or two legs, and you could do this one of two ways. Take your hands out of the equation and just lift up. You can hold it here, lead with the thumbs. If it's too tight, you can lift with one. You can go slightly out to the side, you can go slightly to the center, okay? So that's just creating a different kind of tension, because when you lift a dumbbell, if it's 15 pounds, it weighs 15 pounds here, it also weighs 15 pounds here. With a band, as you're pulling, the tension is more, so it creates a different stimulus. So, I hope you guys like this. I hope you like the shoulder workout. I hope you get a massive pump after you do those swings. And pew!